Good morning, children. Today we are going to start off with page number 23. The same story which we have done, we are going to continue A Day in the Jungle, where we are going to do the question and answers, right, which are in the book. Now, page number 23C we are going to do, right? So you please take out your notebooks, take out just continue after the meanings, okay? If you have place there, just continue. If you don't have any place, after you have done the meanings, you can go to a fresh page, right? And write A Day in the Jungle and start off. See, we are going to do page number 23C, right? I'm sure there is no confusion with this. So please write C dot answer these questions. Right? Now question number 1 we are going to do. Am I clear? Right. So what was the question? Why were the children very excited early in the morning? Why were the children very excited early in the morning? This question you can write from the book. I am not writing the question. I will only be writing the answers. And I am going to type it in a word file as well and send it to you in the group so that you don't have any problem writing. Right? So for now you can just follow what I am teaching on the board. I am going to write the answers as well and read it out for you so that it's easier for you to read and learn, right? So why were the children very excited early in the morning? So the children were very excited early in the morning to wake up to the chirping of the birds, right? So what is the answer? Number 1. The children, you write the question and then write the answer in the book, okay? You write the question first and then write the answer in the book. So the children were very excited The children were very excited early in the morning to wake up to the chirping of the birds. So I'm going to read it out again for you so that it's easier for you to read and learn, right? The children were very excited The children were very excited early in the morning to wake up to the chirping of the birds, right? So the children were very excited to wake up early in the morning to the chirping of the birds. They really loved it, okay? This was the answer for number one. Now question number two. What is question number two? Why had the leopard taken its kill up on the tree? Kill means, I told you, the leopard had killed an animal and had taken it to the on the tree. So it was the food for the leopard, right? So that is the kill. Okay. So what is the answer? The leopard had taken its kill up on the tree. So answer two. The leopard has taken its kill up on the tree so that it does not get snatched away by a tiger or a hyena. Right? This is question number two. Children, I would just request you, when you are writing in your notebook, you are seeing the word file or from the video, you are writing in the notebook, please take care of your spellings. Because when I was going through so many of the notebooks on WhatsApp, the pictures, I saw so many of you have made mistakes in the spelling. So after, when you write, please be a little careful about the spellings and check it again before you click it and send it to me, right? Okay, now number three. Number three, what is the question? I'm sure by now you have written this, number one and number two. Why is the rhino's horn described as its own, very own dagger to fight with? I told you, why? Very own dagger to fight with. Why is it? The rhino has a special feature, which is his horn. And because of that, he protects itself with the horn, right? If he feels that there is a danger, he protects himself with the horn, right? So we are going to write the answer right now. The rhino's horn has been described as its the rhino's horn. Described as, children, its very own dagger to fight with. Its very own dagger. What is a dagger? I told you, children. Dagger is a thick knife. Heavy, chura, okay? Very own dagger. D-A-G-G-E-R. To fight with. Very own dagger to fight with. Because a rhino's horn is a special feature which helps it to protect itself. Because a rhino's horn is a special feature means a special thing which helps it to protect itself, which helps it to protect itself. Again for you, the rhino's horn has been described as its very own dagger to fight with, because a rhino's horn is a special feature which helps it to protect itself, right? I'm sure you're not having any problem right now. Please read it from the board. I'm writing it very clearly for you. I'm sure you're not having any problem with my handwriting anymore. And not to worry, I'm going to upload the word file as well. Okay? Right? Done? Now, I have to rub the board because I don't have place here. Number 4, I'm going to rub the board and start off, right? Are you done? Okay, if you are writing from the board, you can take a screenshot as well and, you know, make it big and then write if you're writing from the board. Okay, right now I'm rubbing the board, okay? Now number 4, okay? What is the answer for number 4? children, why did the family see from the, what did the family see from the machan? What did the family see from the machan, children? We have already learned the story. We have already read the story. I'm sure you must have read the story again, right? Okay. Yes, we have seen what? We have seen langurs, they have seen langurs, they have seen what else? Birds and a tigress with two adorable cubs, right? Yes, this is the answer. So, let us write the answer first. Number 4. Answer 4. The family saw. What did they see? Langurs. Comma, birds, no, I'm sorry, they did not see, they drove again and then they saw the tiger, but from the machan they saw what? Only langurs and birds. So we are going to just rub and write langurs and birds. Right? Okay. Birds from the machan. Okay? Right, children? I'm going to just read it out for you. The family saw langurs and birds from the machan. So what did they see? The family saw langurs and birds from the machan. Right? Now next one. What did the guide ask the ranger and why? What did the guide ask the ranger and why? Why did the guide ask the ranger? Do you remember the answer? Yes. They asked that what did the guide ask to the ranger? Was there any call? Call means animals call. Did the animals call out? Because that is the alarm for a tiger to come in, right? And when the animals call, it means the tiger comes back to its prey, means food, means kill, right? So, I have already explained this to you when I was reading the chapter and explaining the chapter, but still I'm again explaining it to you. And why did he ask him? Because he was tracking down a tiger and they wanted to see a tiger or a tigress, whatever. And then suddenly they heard an alarm call, right? And they saw a tiger and two adorable cubs, right? A tigress and two adorable cubs, right? So, let's write the answer. Number 5. The guide asked the ranger. Whom did he ask? The ranger. Right? The guide asked the ranger if he heard any animal call. If he heard any animal call why? Because he was trying to track down a tiger by listening to the animal's call. Because he was trying to track down a tiger. He was trying to track down a tiger by listening to the animal's call. What was he doing? He was trying to track down a tiger by listening to the again for you. The guide asked the ranger. What did the guide ask the ranger? If he heard any animal call. If he heard any animal call. Why? Because he was trying to track down a tiger by listening to the animal's call. Because he was trying to track down a tiger by listening to an animal's call. Right? Understood? Please read it. I'm giving you some time. You read it and see if it is okay for you. Right? So this was the answer. Fifth answer. So we are done with the question and answers. Section C we have done of page 23 already. Should I rub the board, children? I'm sure you have read it properly. Right. Now, I'm going to start off with the reference to the context, okay? Which is section D, page 23. Section D, page 23. This one, I'll show you in the book. This one, D. Can you all see? Yes. So, let's start off with it. I want you to draw a line after you finish section C and then write D. D. Okay? Read these lines from the story and answer the questions that follow. Read these lines from the story and answer the questions that follow. So, what are the questions? Let's read. Those look like they would really hurt. So who spoke these words? We all know. It's so easy, right? You can write on your own. But I'm going to still write it on the board so that it's easier for you. Number one, A. Which one? Jaya spoke these words. Who spoke? Jaya spoke these words. Right? Number B, what is the question? Number B, what is referred to as they here? What is referred to as they here, children? Very simple, the porcupines. B, the porcupines are referred to as they. Okay? Right? The porcupines are referred to as they. So, next question is, what is the name of the animal being spoken about? What is the name of the animal being spoken about? The name of the animal right. Now I'm going to go to number two. So should I rub the board? Yeah. So next one is number two. Children, these questions are very simple ones. You can write on your own. Since I have just started with, you know, the second chapter, I mean the one poem and one story I have done, but from next time you have to try to write on your own, right? Otherwise, how will you learn how to write English? You have to try all these questions and answers on your own, okay? Right. Now, number two, what is the question? Number two, we humans have remarkable intelligence. With it, not only can we protect ourselves, but also help our animal friends. Okay? So, who spoke these lines? Who spoke these lines? Who spoke these lines? Jaya's mother. Jaya's mother spoke these Sita's mother spoke these lines. Am I clear? Now B, what is the next question? B, why did the speaker say these words? Why did the speaker say these words? The speaker said these words because Jaya wanted to know the special quality of humans. Jaya wanted to know about the special quality of humans. So, the speaker children, Jaya's mother. The speaker was the question. 1 minute. Why did the speaker say these words? Right? So Jaya's mother, who's the speaker, said these. Words because Jaya wanted to know about the special qualities Jaya wanted to know the special qualities of humans, right? That is why she asked. So the speaker said these words. Why did the speaker say these words? Because Jaya wanted to know about the special qualities of humans. Because Jaya wanted to know about the special qualities of humans. Like rhino has a special thing, what? The horn, you know. And there are certain animals have claws because of which they can protect themselves. Then fangs. Okay, so how she wanted to know about human beings, right? So the speaker said these words because Jaya wanted to know about the special qualities of humans, right? I'm sure there is no confusion in this. Please read. Right, now number 2, C. B we have written, now we have read C. What is C? Let's read the question. Were the listeners happy to hear these words? Were the listeners happy? Who are the listeners? Jaya and Varun, yes. So were they happy? The listeners agreed to what their mother said and were very happy. Okay. The listeners agreed to what their mother said were very happy. Okay, so let's read. The listeners agreed to what their mother said and were very happy. So what was the question? Were they happy? Yes, they agreed to what their mother said. They said very true and they were very happy. Okay, so we have done section D, question number 1 and 2, right? Please read the last answer and see if you have any issues, any problems. Right? So I'm going to rub the board right now. Have you read? Right, I'm going to rub the board. Next, we are going to do section E. Section E, let's check out. See, I'll just show you the book here. Section E, discuss, it is written. Since we are not in the classroom, so we cannot share it with the class, but you can do it in the at home and share it with me, right? So what you have to do, list three ways in which human beings can help animals. Okay, so what you do is, in your next section, you can do it in your notebook also and take a fresh page and then, you know, make a table like this. It will look nice in your notebook. Make a table. Divide it into three parts and write it here. Okay? You can divide it into three equal parts and then write it here. What will you write? Three ways in which human beings can help animals. So can you just think about it? How you can help animals? We all know that hunting is not legal anymore. We cannot hunt. If you hunt, what happens? Animals, if you kill animals, then animals will die. And then one fine day, that species will get what? It will be not there anymore. So, we should not hunt. How do you help animals? We should take care of animals. If you see any cat or dog on the street, you should help them if they are in pain, right? So just think about it and write three ways in which you would like to help the animals, okay? So do this and on your own. You can take help from your parents or you can just, you know, research also if you want. On Google and get some ideas and then also you can do, but do it on your own. Okay, I'm not going to tell the answers, right? So I just gave you an idea how to do it and you're going to do it on your own. Click a picture and send it to me, like you click your notebook's picture and you send, right? And if you want, you can make a border also with colored and decorate the border also and the page. That will look very nice. Okay? You can do that. It's like a project, but I'm giving it to you in your notebook. Okay? Right? Right, children. So, this was it. I end my class today here. So, stay safe, stay home. and take care of yourself. Have a wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much.